Welcome to another episode of Let There Be Rock. Today we're going to look at the women of rock and roll. Too often, a history of rock and roll becomes a testosterone fest, and the women are often overlooked. So, by special request, I'm going to put this series out. We're going to look at the women of rock and roll, first from the 60s, then the 70s, 80s, and the 90s to today. On this episode, Women Who Rock, the 1960s. The thrill has gone away. The thrill is gone, baby. The thrill is gone away. You know you done me wrong, baby, and you'll be sorry someday. The year was 1967. The singer, Port Arthur's own Janis Joplin. While Janis Joplin comes out of Texas, she's going to move to San Francisco, join a band called Big Brother and the Holding Company, and they're going to release a song that was first recorded in 1930 by Eddie Head and his family. The song was Down on Me. In 1967, Big Brother and the Holding Company are going to write new lyrics for it, and this song is going to reach number 42 on the charts, narrowly missing the top 40. Janis Joplin, Down on Me, 1967. Janis Joplin had such a great guttural blues growl to her. I've seen a lot of people complain that her voice isn't great. I disagree. I think her voice is full of emotion. You can feel everything Janis is singing about. There's actually a more upbeat version of this song that was released posthumously on her live album that didn't chart quite so well, but it's a little more popular today. It's the one of the greatest hits albums today. Our second song of 1967 comes from the psychedelic band Jefferson Airplane, later on known as Jefferson Starship and then simply Starship. The song was White Rabbit. It was penned by Grace Slick, and it was kind of a psychedelic, trippy song about Alice in Wonderland's little experiences. People read a lot of stuff into this song, but Grace Slick insisted it was nothing but a fairy tale put to song. Jefferson Airplane, White Rabbit, 1967. What a great bass line. This song did reach number 8 on the Billboard Top 100. Music is hypnotic.
One pill makes you larger, and one pill makes you small. And the ones that mother gives you don't do anything at all. Go ask Alice.
A little bit of suggestions of drugs there. The little ones mama gave you don't do nothing at all. Rolling Stone rated this 478 on the 500 most important songs of rock and roll. Grace Slick had a big voice. Grace Slick still has a big voice.
When the men on the chessboard get up and tell you where to go.
What I love about Grace Slick's lyrics is that it's more than a song, it's literature. In 1969, the haunting voice of Marianne Faithfull leaped off the radio with a song co-penned by none other than Keith Richards and Mick Jagger of the Rolling Stones. Marianne Faithfull at this point was the love interest of Mick Jagger. The song, Sister Morphine, the year 1969, Marianne Faithfull. We visited this song before, but the song is so powerful. Marianne Faithfull is one of those artists that's often forgotten today, but she was incredibly important in the late 60s and early 70s. I don't think you could have a Blondie without a Marianne Faithfull. I like that hiccup in the voice. That goes back to rockabilly and early Motown sound. Now I can feel a little bit of that Celtic style in there.
Oh, you see, I'm not that strong.
You can definitely hear the influence of the Rolling Stones on Marianne Faithfull.
Such faith.
Tell me, Sister Murphy, when are you coming round again? Oh, I don't think I can wait that long. Oh, you see, my pain is so strong. It sounds in my ear. Tell me, Sister Murphy, how long have I been lying here? What am I doing in this?
In 1969, Coven came about, and Coven was one of the early adopters of the shock rock metal sound. They had a phenomenal lead singer, and their big hit in 69 was The White Witch of Rose Hall. It's based on a legend of a ghost that haunted Rose Hall in Jamaica. But Coven's version of this is absolutely incredible. Let's listen to a little bit of it. They're oftentimes forgotten about, but that's sad. I think Coven is ripe for a covering today. I could hear Hart covering this song.
The white witch of Rose Hall, the devil she could.
The last I read, covered and still touring.
Mr. Rutherford came one day into Montego Bay, to the great house, an accountant man, and a farmer had to have his man.
I can hear her. She's a predecessor to Ronnie James Dio's sound with Black Sabbath. I think Bruce Dickinson owes a lot to Coven. In the modern age, I don't think you could have a Lizzie Hale with Hellstorm without Coven.
Rose Hall, the devil she could call.